What's up, Griffin Nation? I'm Chris Hernandez, and it's time for another edition of On the Hill with Hernandez. Baseball opened up the CAC schedule against Concordia College this past weekend. Let's take a look at the highlights. Clippers and Griffs at Plymouth White Marsh High School. CHC looking for their fifth win of the season after their Florida trip. Matt Kress on the mound for CHC in game one of two from PW. Second inning, Joe Impound Duglia with a hit down the right field line. Hermes Abreu chugging around to score. RBI triple puts Concordia up one early. Manufacturing runs in the fourth. Leadoff hit by pitch. Single to right through the hole. Small ball sack bunt by Tyler Eppel. We'll move the runner to the third. Next batter, RBI ground out by Empaduglia again, now up two. Getting late, Smalley smacks one at right field to lead off the seventh inning and gives CHC some much-needed life. Now here's the lack of execution. John Candidas can't get the sacrifice down for out number one. Pinch runner Sam Barletta gets hosed trying to steal second for out number two. Three pitches later, Meech Isaac strikes out looking. Inning is over. He'll get on the board. Matt Owens reaches on the error by the third baseman on the throw. He'll head to second base. Craig scores. Now CHC is only down by one. 4-1, Clippers in the ninth, two outs. Amir Rizal grounded to shortstop. That'll do it. CHC drops game one by the final score of 4-1. Matthew Kress went 8 2/3 innings. 4 runs, 8 hits, and striking out 7, but he was outdone by Dylan Lawrence, going the distance with 2 walks, 1 run, and 14 punchouts. 3-4-5 for Chestnut Hill. Craig Owens and Gillum went 5 for 10 with 1 run, but the CHC bouts were as cold as the weather. 9 runners left on base and had a really rough time getting men in from scoring position. For that and more, here's Coach Spratt.
Coach, fifth inning, you go out to talk to Matt, first and third. I believe it was 1 out. He got out of the gym. What'd you tell him?
We told him just to pitch through it, you know, make sure Gil threw. I think we threw the guy out stealing there, and we were able to get through that. Matt pitched great tonight.
So down one going to the ninth. What was that decision to go with Kress in the ninth?
I mean, why not? I mean, he was outstanding. You know, there was nobody better. I'd rather have him on the mound than anybody else.
A lot of strikeouts today, just a little bit late. Was they doing a good job just keeping guys off balance? What do you think their game plan was?
Well, we faced him before. He beat us 2 years ago as a sophomore. You know, we kind of knew what he was going to do. He likes to work fast. He throws a lot of strikes. And, you know, I think we didn't make adjustments that we needed to as the game wore on. And he was outstanding.
Yeah, you mentioned about not really making adjustments. 9 runners left on base, 1 for 6 runners in scoring position. Was it just hard to get runs across? Or what do you think the execution plan was? And what are your thoughts on that?
Well, we were really poor at it, and they were better. I mean, they didn't have a hard time executing when they needed to. We didn't get a bunt down when we needed to. And, you know, it was a frustrating way to go about it. I think we played a little tight in the game one.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck with the next game.
All right, thank you.
Game two didn't go our way either with a 6-5 loss. The next time the Griffs are in action will be tomorrow at Lincoln University at 3 p.m. But with some snow heading into the area, that game may be canceled. So if you're looking for the next conference game, it'll be this Friday at home versus the University of the Sciences at 1 p.m. That's all for today. Thanks for spending some time with me on the Hill. I'm Chris Hernandez, and I'll see you next time.